Hey, good optometry morning. So this eye drop is the most popular drop for dry eyes in Europe, but you can't have it. Hey, I'm Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor. And in this video, I'm going to be revealing what this drop is and how you might be able to get it. But we want to also tell you why this drop is so special. But first, let's talk a little bit about dry eye and what that is. So dry eye disease is a real problem. It causes gritty, sandy, burning, itchy, even watery eyes. Yes, watery eyes can be a symptom of a dry eye. And one of the first things that people reach for are lubricating drops. But there are so many of them. If you go to the supermarket or the pharmacy or the drugstore, you're gonna see a plethora of eye drops. And how are you gonna know which one is right for you? Because there's so many and they're all claiming to be the best for this, best for that, the most soothing, the most relief. How do you know which one is the best eye drop for you? And so a lot of people end up just assuming, well, all these drops are the same, so it doesn't really matter which one I use. But dry eye specialists all agree that there are three things that will make up the perfect composition for a dry eye drop. So number one, you want an eye drop that prevents your tears from evaporating off too quickly. So there are two main types of dry eye disease. There's the aqueous deficient dry eye disease where you actually don't produce enough tears. And then there's the evaporative type of dry eye disease where your tears are evaporating off too quickly. And 80-90% of people with dry eye disease have the evaporative type of dry eye disease. And basically what this means, it's not the quantity of tears. You have lots of tears. It's the quality of the tears that's the problem. And basically, you have some glands in your upper and your lower lids. They're called the meibomian glands. And these are oil glands that produce the part of the tear that prevents them from evaporating off your eye too quickly. And the problem is a lot of people with evaporative dry eye disease, their meibomian glands are either blocked or they're inflamed, and so they're not working properly, and your tear composition really is not very good. And for that reason, your tears evaporate off too quickly. So when designing the perfect lubricating drop, you want a drop that mixes with your tears to create a composition that prevents your tears from evaporating off and creates a nice thick layer of tears that stays there for a long period of time. Because lubricating drops, you put them in, they don't help make those glands work better, and they don't cure anything, and they're just mixing with your tears, and they work for a period of time, and then after a while they dissipate and things are back to the way they were. All right, so the second thing, if you're designing the perfect eye drop for dry eye disease, is you want an eye drop that has a composition that is conducive for healing the tissue on the surface of your eye. So if you have evaporative dry eye disease, a couple of things happen. One, your tears evaporate off, exposing the very delicate cells on the surface of your cornea to the air, and they start to dry out and get damaged and irritated, and that causes discomfort, burning, itching, blurred vision, all the symptoms that you're having. So you want something that helps heal those. Also, when your tears evaporate off, the concentration of the salts and the electrolytes in those tears goes way up. So you have what we call a hyperosmotic tear that's full of inflammatory components because they're not diluted down that cause more reactions, and actually it causes a cascade to increase the amount of dry eye that you have. And number three, experts agree in the perfect eye drop for dry eye disease, you want a preservative-free eye drop. So in a lot of the eye drops out there, you're gonna see a chemical called BAK, which stands for benzalkonium chloride. And basically this is a popular preservative, which works really well to preserve drops so they last longer. However, it's kind of toxic and irritating to the superficial tissues of your eye. If you use it on a regular basis, it can irritate that tissue and it actually can cause your dry eye to increase sometimes. So if we can have an eye drop that doesn't have a preservative, that's perfect. Okay, so what is this magical drop that's so popular in Europe? It's called Thealoz Duo. So Thealoz Duo is produced by a company called THEA, which is located in France. It's an independent pharmaceutical company started by the Chabray family. And this pharmaceutical company is only dedicated to producing products for the eye. That's their specialty. That's what they know. And they've created Thealoz Duo as their answer to treating dry eye disease. So Thealoz Duo has two active ingredients which help fight dry eye disease. It has 3% trehalose and it has 0.15% sodium hyaluronate. So trehalose is not often found in a lot of dry eye drops. And what it does is it helps stabilize cell membranes. Those membranes on the surface of your eye, it helps stabilize the cells to prevent those cells from being damaged from dry eyes. And it also helps stabilize the salt balance in the tears so you don't get that hypertonic salt solution that's full of inflammatories that are increasing the dry eye response. And sodium hyaluronate is actually a common ingredient in a lot of eye drops. And what it does, it helps make your tears a little bit more sticky so they don't wash away as quickly as they would otherwise. So let's talk about what Thealoz Duo actually does. So Thealoz Duo increases the tear film thickness and the residency time of the tear on your eye. So what does that mean? So they did a study with Thealoz Duo and they looked at how long this stays on your eye and how well it works. And after about 10 minutes, Thealoz Duo increased tear film thickness by 40% more than just a drop with hyaluronic acid alone. Not only did it increase the tear thickness, but it lasted a long time. Basically, Thealoz Duo maintained a significant increase in the tear film thickness for nearly 4 hours and almost 6 times longer than a drop with just hyaluronic acid alone. And what's more, Thealoz Duo reduced inflammatory markers, and after only about 2 months, those inflammatory markers that were present in dry eye were reduced by an average of about 58%, and because it restores the normal osmotic balance of the tears. So basically, Thealoz Duo stabilizes the tear film, creates a more natural environment that helps protect and heal the tissue on the surface of your eye. Okay, so what does that mean for your symptoms with dry eyes? If you start using this drop, is it going to work for you? So they looked at people that had tried this drop for about 5 weeks and asked them what their symptoms were. And those patients with moderate to severe dry eye symptoms had those symptoms reduced by about 60% compared to others that weren't on this drop. And about 1 in 4 people with dry eye symptoms found that their symptoms were significantly reduced or gone after 5 weeks. What have I found in my clinic? So Thealoz Duo is probably a drop that I recommend the most often to my patients that have dry eye disease because I know that it works. And how do I know that it works? Because my patients keep coming back asking for it. And if we don't have it in stock, they're saying, call me when the drop comes in. I need more. I'm almost out. Now, the third thing that experts really wanted in an eye drop, I haven't even talked about. It's the preservative free. So Thealoz Duo comes in a bottle and usually when an eye drop comes in a bottle, that means that it has some preservatives in it because you can't have that much solution in there without it getting contaminated and needing some preservative to prevent that. However, THEA has developed a proprietary technology in their bottle that allows them to have an eye drop that is preservative-free in a convenient bottle, which is fantastic. Otherwise, you have to use these individual little tubes, which can work, but they're a little bit more of a hassle. So Thealoz Duo is a preservative-free formulation, and that formulation can allow you to use that bottle for up to 6 months without replacing it and still being safe from contamination. And the nice thing about being preservative-free is that this drop can be used safely with any contact lens. So if you suffer from dry eye and wearing a contact lens, Thealoz Duo is a fantastic drop that you can use with your contact lens. All right, so where can you get Thealoz Duo? Now, it's available all across Europe. So if you're traveling in Europe, you can stop into most pharmacies or drugstores and you will probably find it. And you may want to pick yourself up a bottle of Thealoz Duo. Now, if you're in North America, it could be a little bit trickier. In Mexico, you can get Thealoz Duo over the counter in most drugstores. In Canada, Thealoz Duo is available over the counter. However, it is not sold in retail stores. So you're not going to see it in the big box stores or even in pharmacies. You're only going to find it in eye clinics. So a lot of eye doctors know how well this drop works, and so they carry it in their clinics for resale for patients. Now in the US, that's a little bit trickier because the Thealoz Duo formulation is not available in the United States. They have another drop made by THEA, which is over the counter, and it has some trehalose in it, but it's not the active ingredient, which means it's not as much of it and it's not as important of a component in it, and it doesn't have any sodium hyaluronate in it. So some people might say, some doctors might say, oh, this is the same as Thealoz Duo, but it's not. So if you live in the United States and you're looking to get some Thealoz Duo, you might have to go across the border either into Canada or into Mexico, or maybe just take a trip to Europe and pick yourself up a bottle of the most popular eye drop from Europe. And with that, have a great optometry day.